Unless you're creating Word documents strictly for yourself, at some point you'll likely want to share your documents with others, maybe even collaborate on them with other people. That's going to be the focus in this chapter, beginning with an old-fashioned method that's still very popular, and that is to simply print your document out. We're going to look at some of the print options as we work with our Tech Connect document, Tech Connect 09. You'll find that in the Chapter 9 folder of your exercise files. You can see from the bottom left corner, we have 6 pages in total. There's the total number of words at the bottom. If we wanted to print this out, we simply click the File tab and then go down to Print. Control P, as in print, is your keyboard shortcut. It's going to open up this dialog, the print dialog. From here, you're going to see a nice little thumbnail representation of the first page in your document. And you can go through this using the arrow or navigation buttons to see what it looks like. You can zoom in and out to get a feel for side-by-side pages, for example, or zoom in to really look at the content itself. Using the arrows, though, will let you go back and forth through those pages. If it's ready to print, it's time to go over here to the left-hand side and look at some of the options. For example, up here, copies. Whatever you chose last time you printed is going to appear here. For me, it's 3. You might see 1. But we can use these up and down arrows to change the number of copies. We can even type in a number if we wanted to, like 5. Next, you'll see your own default printer, but click this dropdown. There are some other options. You may have multiple printers connected, maybe even on a network, and you can select them from here. If you're like me and only have one, there are some other options, such as printing to PDF. This is the same as saving to PDF, but it's going to create a PDF version of your document, a read-only document. Same thing for Microsoft XPS, the Microsoft version of a read-only document. You can even send to OneNote if you wanted to. If you use OneNote and you want to send this document to your notebook, you can do it right from here. We're going to leave our default printer selected as though we're going to print the pages in this document, 5 copies. Notice down below, for me, I see print one-sided. Your printer might be able to print two-sided. Mine's not. So printing one-sided is the default here. Of course, with a 6-page document printing 5 copies, I want it to be collated. I don't want to see 5 page ones come out, then 5 page twos, and so on, and have to do the collating myself after the fact. Why not let Word do it? That way, all 6 pages will print out. Then all 6 pages will print out again. Everything will be in order. Notice we can change things like orientation. We could switch to landscape from here, the paper size, change up our margins, and down at the bottom, the number of pages per sheet. Now, if you're going to hand this out like a handout as opposed to giving people the real document, you might want to squeeze a couple of pages on each sheet of paper. Click the dropdown. You'll see some presets here, like 2 pages per sheet. Clicking that is going to print smaller versions of your page, 2 of them side by side in a landscape, and people will be able to look at the pages, not necessarily work with the document the way you intend it. Click the dropdown. Again, you could go even smaller if you wanted to with 4, 6, 8, or 16 pages per sheet. Those would be tiny little thumbnails. Let's go back to 1 page per sheet. When you're ready to print, you simply click the print button. And off they go, using the settings you've selected down below. Lastly, if you wanted to print 1 or 2 pages here and there, you'll notice printing all the pages is the default. Click the drop-down if you want to print just the page you're looking at, the current page. Or, for example, if you want to print out something you don't see, like the document information that's stored with your document, properties, file name, the author, the date and time it was last saved. You can see styles down here, lots of things you can print out besides the document itself. You can even choose to print only the odd or even pages. For me and my printer that prints one-sided only, this is a handy option. I could print out all the odd pages, then turn the stack upside down, put it back into the printer tray, and print out the even pages on the back. I get two-sided printing the old-fashioned manual way thanks to these options. But let's just leave it at printing all pages. Again, if you wanted to print out individual pages, there's one last field down here to talk about. Click in there. If you want to print pages 1 and 3, for example, you would type a 1, 3. If you wanted pages 1 through 3, you could type in 1-3. or maybe 1 through 3 and 6, comma 6 at the end. Any combination thereof will allow you to print exactly the pages you want. Otherwise, you can see we're printing all pages in our document. Clicking print will send them off to your printer, and when you're done, you'll hit the back arrow to go back to your document. That's the old-fashioned way of sharing documents with other people, printing them out here in Word 2019.